Yo, all right. So I see you're still interested in the Minecraft. Well, that's cool because I got right here for you. Something I forget what I called. This is okay. What I got here. I built this once I built the SS McCarly there, and what I called it's like a water temple. It's just a stupid temple I made jutting out of this big chunk glitch here. Because in case you haven't noticed. So far, a lot of my world did kind of glitch when generating, so there was just this big open cliff, and you could see it really clearly from that place, the lower district. So I just I'll polish it up a bit, make it look cool. I just want to point out that this jungle temple spawned in the middle of a snow biome, which is very good. Very happy about that. It actually does look kind of cool there. Anyways, I made. This big path, it derives off from the path to the university, and it goes into this hillside. And basically, I just made like these little hermit huts. And I think they're actually pretty cozy. Little hermit hut, blah, blah, blah. Just keep breathing. Hermit huts. So most of them are designed like this. They've got colorful walls. That's something that I wanted to start working with once I was done with Regius, was these colorful walls. So I made them yellow and orange. Like, I did have colorful walls there, but like, I wanted to make it more colorful. Of course, I used a lot more quartz. That's something that I didn't use much in Regius. So just gonna show here this big hall I made. Kind of looks like a mall. I have no idea what inspired me to do this, but then I made all these rooms that look onto the hall. All these apartment stuff. I made this market. Not sure. I don't even know what I forget what I call this place, but that's what I made, and that's where it is. So, next place I'll show. I missed a few places over here. This one you might have been curious about because it's kind of been in the background for a while. Is a graveyard with a big tower. And of course, yeah, I'll be the first to admit, this world has a lot of toilets. A, a lot of toilets, and B, a lot of graveyards. So maybe I'm saying something about taking a dump and dying, but maybe I just kind of feel like it's a necessary thing. But anyways, that's my big. I just wanted to build a nice tower as a big central point. So there's like a some dude's tomb or whatever, and you go up here, you can see it better through the glass. I don't know why I made it. Well, actually, I have little reason for making this entire thing other than just being bored and wanting to create something. So yeah, usually I was just bored one night and I would have built something like this, because I think this build maybe took 1 or 2 days only. See, you got your crypts. This crypt has a cool design. It's kind of weird. Anyways, I also gave it a nice, creepy old tree. Because why not? I just also want to show this ruined tower. I think I was supposed to make it a bell tower. I just think it looks really good ruined. It's the best ruined thing I'd made. Because you can tell it's a tower and you can tell it's ruined. So as long as it does that, I'm very happy. What order should I go? I'll show you this here. This here looks like a church in Venice. Although I made houses based off the Venice houses over there. Oh, excuse me. See, I'm getting sick of. Didn't say that already. I made Venice houses over there, but I didn't make a church. So here's the church. The Venice church. And I tried to make it. I built it here, and then I decided I didn't want to build anything else, so then I made it ruined. That looks pretty cool. See the bridge I blasted? It's down there. Put a bunch of rubble down there, make it seem blasted. And I tried to make it satanic in here, but it didn't really work. I actually remember scaring myself once because, like, I made it satanic and then. Yeah, you got stuff like this. I'm gonna drink one of these. And here's the new... This is what I created. This is my go-to staircase design, this spiral staircase. Although usually it's slabs, this one has stairs. But anyways, I just want to show up to the roof. Because you do have a pretty nice view from there. What? My mouse isn't sensitive at all, or it's too sensitive. So there you go. Got your bells still. And your nice view. There you go. Now where I'm going to take you is, well, you can see it from here. My second, oh, I remember putting that there. Smiley face. You can't see it without the night vision. Just like random rubble there I put. This is what I call Klostiorn. I have no idea where that name comes from, but it sounded okay, so I put it here. And it's another Nordic design place. So, again, I was playing Skyrim, and I just kind of built it. Klostiorn, as they call it. I call it. Whatever. Oh, lag. That just completely lagged out. Oh, God. Basically, this ship, again, it's like the one between Elandria and Treetop. You hit that, and it takes you to Regius over there. But I really like the hull here. All the rest of the things are just kind of there, because it looked lonely without it. Here's hot springs. I put the spider webs as smoke to make it seem hot. But you know, it's not hot until I hit it. Here's a giant ice thing. And what I've actually done is, I'm not going to go down there to show it, but I've actually connected these things here over to the water at the base of that. Why? I don't know. Anyways, let's zoom out to show it. Because it's a nice freaking... If I do say so myself, it's pretty nice. And, well, let's head in. So I got my infinitely burning fire. Which, like, I was really concerned about it burning down all this wood, because there's a lot of wood. And it's really important in here. But, fortunately, it's not burning anything, so thank God. But yeah, just showing the beams. I made sure to use a lot of arches, because that's something I noticed with Nordic architecture. I could grab that if I wanted to survive a mobile. It's just a little message about the place. Over here, just got your special armor. And your kitchen. Here's the spiral staircase I created. Just one slab up, and there you go. It works. It looks okay. That's all I need. Go out to one of the balconies. Actually, it's kind of... It looks really cool on the outside of this place, but it's pretty empty on the inside because I couldn't find many good places to put stuff. But, you know, like, there's your front balcony stuff. Snuff? Stuff. No, I said stuff. Whatever. I'm sick. Forgive me. And here's your master's seat. Whenever the big cheese in these parts sits there. This is the most northernmost build I made in this map. I can't go much further than this. Further north. And, basically, you have this giant hallway to the outside with all the armor stands trying to make it look cool. And, it leads to this. And I don't know why, what this is. I think I decided this, like, religion thing, of course. Because... Like, when you analyze real architecture, anything that looks cool really is only made for religion, you know? Like, not many of focal points are made for, well, it's either religion or just a big cheese who has a big ego. These are mammoth skulls, and I worked for like 3 hours trying to perfect them, and they look pretty damn good, especially with the blocks. Right? Would you have known that without me saying? I hope so, because I worked hard on those. And yeah. That's just basically it for here. Now where I'm going to take you is this way. I'm going to fly there, because it's much easier. So I'll just give you one quick flyby by the city. Actually, it's gonna see, this is what I have to deal with when I'm going around quickly. I'm just gonna go to the grand entrance and take the path. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay, we're good. So the path, like, it's kind of just formal. Like, you need a way to get in, but eventually I felt like I might as well go somewhere besides just one place, which was Elandria Town, up until I made this little path here. So, you go down, there's little cocoa bean farm, trying to make it seem, you know, like there's a reason to have a big jungle here. As you can see, like, the length of these vines tell you how old, or like how long I've worked in the presence of these, of this jungle. So, like, it's a really old jungle because they're all to the ground. And therefore, I worked my dick off around this place. So, this was Glory Gulch Mine, which is like a mine I made in a creative mode. Try and make it look like it's being used. So, I'm not sure what people think of it. I think it's okay. Oh, losing my voice, actually. But that's why I'm doing this today, because I only just started feeling sick today. And by the time I lost my voice, I'll have a lot of stuff to edit. So that said, path to Plateau Gardens. So what I did this in a summer one day. I think summer of grade 10, maybe. You go this way. And I made some gardens. Bunch of flowers, bunch of nice trees, all these vines, there's glowstone hanging from the trees, just because, you know, I started feeling very natural, so I felt this was necessary, and, like, I kind of went crazy with the vines, so they kind of obscure a lot, not too much, but yeah, they just added in all these new flowers and stuff, so I'm like, I just used them. Quite actually like this place. A little spiral to the top of this tree. I had to destroy the top, otherwise there's no way to make a viewpoint. But anyways, I want to... Well, first of all, show you this. I will set it to daytime. This is what I call... What did I call this place? Willow Valley. Because I planted a bunch of willows around the water bodies. So, and right there, that's a mountain. I called something else. I just want to direct your attention to this here. Remember the first episode of this tour, I said that I built a nether portal underground. It spawned me underground in the nether. So I wasn't having any of that. So I jumped in, you know, grabbed a bunch of obsidian. Then I walked all the way from Scuba Town, which is like way, way over there. And I finally wound up here. And then I made a new portal, and guess where it put me? In the exact same underground cave. So, wasn't too very pleased about that, but, you know. I killed off the portal, and there you have it now. Not much more to it. And then, you know, after I went all this way and made this portal, that's when I decided, okay, I'll just spawn in a blaze rod, because I'm getting pissed off with this crap. So, I'm going to direct your attention right now to this mountain. And what does this say? Oakshade Lake Docks. Okay. I try to make this like a natural looking valley. And I think I succeeded. I don't know why I covered this mountain with wheat, but it looks pretty cool. Anyways, you have the staircase all the way up. And then you have the historical site. Here marks the signing of the Three Kingdoms unto the Silver Federation. And again, that's more of the lore I came up with. I don't really care too much about lore anymore when making my stuff. I just kind of make it. So, yeah. Anyways, there's your, that I will get to later, because that is one of my favorite builds in the place. In the whole world. I'll take you down to rest of Willow Valley right now. So, right here is a little chateau I made. It's pretty friggin' nice, I think. Basically, the idea of it, I built this first, this chateau, and then, you know, I was still bored once it was done, so then I built that one. It doesn't look the best from here, it looks better when I show you from here. And, you know, even though that chateau's okay, I kind of wish I just left this one here. Because, like, that one, you know, This one I thought looked best when it was alone, but it's not like I'm gonna tear this one down just because it looks better without it. Because it's not a bad build. It's just, you know, I built this with, like, in mind that, you know, maybe it would be a cool place to live in the middle of this really nice valley. But, you know, that's okay. I'm perfectly okay with my scuba town over there. I was just going to quickly show you the design of this place. I like the roof because it's open at the top, but there's also some living space. So, yeah, not sure what I called this one. It's just kind of a chateau. There's a roof in better detail. And over here. I'll just show you around this one real quick. This is kind of more a medieval style. Yeah, so basically, I made sure they both had bridges of some sort because I wanted water to be a main focus in this valley. Because I already had a few lakes, so I added a few more because I wanted to surround them with willows so that I could call it Willow Valley. Anyways, just quickly show you through here. I remember watching them listening to a bunch of Vsauce videos when I made this one. So I didn't actually listen to music when making these. Yeah. So it's just kind of a like small medieval chateau sort of design. Not chateau because it's not really French or anything. Kind of like a mini castle. I don't know. I'm proud of Willow Valley. I think it's one of my better looking builds. One of the last parts of Willow Valley, though, is over here. Or the last part, sorry. Got this big lake and then just a little old rusty old watch temple. Where just some like crazy old alchemist or somebody lived. Not sure why I made that. Because the mountain looked okay as it was. But it's there now. What can you do? Okay. Now you saw that thing I had over there. And I know you want to see what it's all about. It's one of the craziest things I've friggin' made. Oh man, such a godsend, these wings. Okay, if it spawns in, and there you go. This here, I built in one day. Believe it or not. And guess what I called it? La Villa Strangiato. And if anybody listens to Rush, that's a like 10-minute instrumental Rush song. And basically what I did is I listened to the song, and it's sort of about like a dream that Alex Lifeson had, and he was in like, I'm assuming from the title and all the names of the different segments, that is, he's like being chased by monsters through a weird sort of compound. And since he called it La Villa Strangiato, I'm assuming it's a little like Spanish looking, so that's why I tried to make this so weird and Spanish looking. So what I did, plunked it right in the middle of this desert island. I put all these fancy planters around it and inside of it, and then I just tried to make every location unique. Made sure to use all of those all of these orange sandstone bricks. Made sure to use the acacia and dark oak wood. And see, like things like this, I added in weird looking windows. Pointlessly doubled up tops there. And once you get inside, it gets even weirder. This is a weird segment because like it goes around this tiny body of water just for no reason. Just try to make it as weird as possible. And it doesn't, I've had a hard time fitting it into the lore, but I've sort of figured it out in my head, although I haven't written it anywhere. Anyways, here's the inside. Buenos Notches mean Freunds. This is actually what I've left trails of, like, the different names of the song, like the different parts. So I'm pretty sure the first part of the song is Buenos Noches, Mein Freunds. So I think I went this way first. I also put in a few of my own weird little signs. So up here, I think I got another one. Monsters. Yep, that's part of the song. It's because I really like that song, and like, I feel like instead of tributing it by covering it, which I can play it, except for the solo, I do know the song. A good way to tribute like make a tribute to it is to make a physical form of it in some way. Well, it's not physical, it's digital. Right? It's like a different form of art honoring a song. It's like two playing off each other. And you know, I would consider my building here art because the way I see it, when you see those big Lego creations people make, do you consider that art? And I mean, that's part of the reason why I like Minecraft so much. Because in creative mode, unlike I like survivor mode, but creative mode's like my best mode because like I've always loved playing with Lego, and I've Lego all over my room. Right, still from a kid. But the problem with Lego is it costs a lot of friggin' money. But with Minecraft, you just spend like $20, I think it is. It was $20 when I bought it. And then this is what you got. You can just have these huge open worlds and just build whatever you want. Be it that a villa based on a Rush song or whatever you want. And that's why I've enjoyed it so much. So I'm pretty sure I hid Danforth and Pape. I think that was the name of a segment of the song. I'm trying to locate these all in here. And you can sort of observe. See, like, I made weird things like these two beds. Oh, come on. Up here, I think I had another sign, maybe. Nope, just another weird two beds. Goo. One particular one aspect of this build that I wanted to make sure I did was there's only one real entrance to like the outside. Like there are a few, there's like a balcony and you can get into the courtyard, but there's only one entrance that like you can get to the other side by not falling off. You know what I'm trying to say? No, you don't. This room's interesting because it's another tribute to Rush. Basically, you have Villa Strangiato's from the Hemispheres album, and I put some of the artwork that came with that album here. So these are two brains, and I think this was another thing I tried to make. This one's a bit... I think this one's the cover I tried to make. It didn't work so well as that one. But, you know, I was just experimenting with this. But, yeah, you got weird rooms like this, just full of pumpkins and melons. What is this? Electrics in Wonderland? I think that was... So, yeah, I'm having a hard time figuring out which one's been named after part of the songs. And which one... which one I created. I think I only came up with two. Anyway, here's the balcony I was talking about. There's one weird room. I haven't taken you to the courtyard yet, but I will. Where's the weird room? Here it is. I just filled this one with doors. Made a sort of maze. I don't really feel like solving it. What's this one here? The Waltz of the Shreves. More lines. So, right here, this was the pointless surrounding the water part I told you about. Oh, my voice. The Journey of Dionysus. I came up with that one. I definitely know I came up with that one. Journey of the God of the Wine. I think there's another one I threw up here. No, this one's just completely empty. And that's like the only room that's completely empty. That's not like a hallway or some other connecting room. Here's like a random suite. Like people could actually live up here. Kind of weird. That was the point of the build. Make something weird. I mean, like, I've made other weird places, but this is the weirdest. Because without me explaining that it's part of a song, to sleep perchance to dream, then there's no way you would know. Okay, I'm just going to quickly blast off down to the entrance of the courtyard. You can see in better detail the width of this place. With all the lights, this could actually make a pretty spooky, like, cave dungeon in the game. But I die. Grass. And there's my, main route, and you just have this one little door leads you to the courtyard. I actually really like the design of the courtyard. Like, I'd rock a courtyard with this design. So, I'm pretty. I hid one more somewhere. This courtyard, there's, yeah, it's just a bunch of those tree planters and flower pastures. Oh, right, yeah. I like this one. I used the quote. So it's like, oh, what's in here? Then you turn around. Never turn your back on a monster. There you go. I gotcha. Might be something up top, too. But I think it's just empty. Yeah. Anyways. Last little Villa Strangiato, man. I really like this build. And, okay, got a few more things to show. This is the Meta Cresta. Basically, the idea is... they take... this is what I call the Royal River. As, like, supposedly a big trading river. Even though it, like... this is the river that I built the castle on top of. So, the idea is... they turn around big ships. And they let little ships go on. So, like, that's basically the boats... you know, like, hold on. That's basically, like, these boats, the only things that can fit through there. But it's kind of like a political little fortress, sort of. Yeah. And supposedly they open it here, and then you could get into Autumndale, which is just a little... it's a little town. I felt like building in a, that's a really weird tree. Little town I felt like building in the birch and oak forest. So... yeah, that's all it really is. It's a little town. You got your little meeting hall in here, which I somehow managed to keep from setting on fire. Your giant chimney, which is kind of useless. And, your... I think I wanted this to resemble an abandoned observatory this year. Well, it's definitely supposed to be abandoned, but, not sure what building is supposed to be. Anyways, it... eventually, I just decided that I wanted it to be a logging town. And there you go. Logs. Okay. One more thing. Two more things, actually. I forgot to show the glacier. Yeah. Believe it or not, I actually built a glacier. Why? I don't know. I like glaciers. But yeah, you got all the fjords down there. You got it slowly working up this mountain, I'd like to say. And, this was a huge, I want to drink this to show it, but this is actually just a huge cave that I filled with water. The idea it's from this melting glacier. Yeah. Can't actually explain why I decided to just put a glacier in. Okay, down here is the last part of Mia Terra. The, third video that I've taken to show it off. This year's what I called Herobrine's Reef. And if I could rename it, I would, but I'm not going to because I don't like changing things that I did a long time ago in this because, I don't know, it's just like out of respect for my improvement in building stuff. So yeah, I call it Herobrine's Reef. I'm going to keep calling it. And it's just a bunch of rocks sticking out of the sea. A bunch of boats caught in it. I made a lot... I tried to make it mysterious, because, like, how could they get boat get all the way up here? How could boat get there? And then, I don't know why I made a pissed off monkey head, but there's one. And, a nice, place to hang out next to this, badly spawned chunks is you got just a little log cabin. And this is, like, the coziest log cabin I made, man. Like, look at how cozy that is. I'd stay there. You can go outside, you got your little balcony there, your fireplace next to a giant death pit, and you can look out upon the giant death ship graveyard. But you know what? I'd live here. I think out of all the places I've built in this world, and I'm not kidding, this would be my preferred place to live. Like, in real life. Even though, like, the idea is, like, there's mega waves that, like, kill off all those things there. Still, I like this log cabin. And that does it for Mia Terra right now. The first little country I made in this world. And on the next video, I'm going to show you the smaller But still I'd say pretty impressive. Other country, I forgot what I named. I called it Luria once, like Lura or IA, but then I found out that's really similar to Lunia, which is like, I read a, it's a game, I think, from somewhere, and I don't want to rip anything off. And you know what? Mia Terra, actually, I would very much like to change, because it is just Latin for my world, and that's kind of stupid. But I didn't want to change it now, because I just wanted to get this tour done. So there's the Villa Strangiato. Bask in its glory. Oh, shoot. I have all these things. I forgot about them. And see you next time, and we will have a look at the next world.